guys, it's Ivana Cadaver, and I am here at the San Fernando Valley Comic Book Convention with
Juliette Reed.
And Juliette, you know what? You come from Hollywood royalty. I mean, really, when you and I talk, we were talking a little bit earlier, your entire family's in the business. You have a museum that you have. So let's talk a little bit about that and about your family.
Oh, okay, my family, where, and I'll hold this up, it makes it a lot easier. They were TV and motion picture cowboys. They were Cactus Mack, Glenn Strange, who was also the Frankenstein monster, and Rex Allen, the Arizona cowboy. So they've all had their little dips into science fiction as well. And it's a real interesting rounded out life.
You were introduced to this life what age? I mean, what?
When I grew up, I thought everybody's family were cowboys and actors because they were. And the valley was built by two different industries, aerospace and the entertainment industry. And all of my neighbors, I grew up with the Connors, Steve Connors, Chuck Connors, son sitting next to me. I grew up with the Connors and the Mitchums and the Bridges and everybody, you know, the whole valley. You couldn't go anywhere. So it was just normal. That's what normal life was in the 60s in the San Fernando Valley.
So it inspired you to just continue on with that tradition.
It did. I had my own career. I spent, I got married young, had my family young, and then I went back to work. I did things kind of backwards. And I worked for 10 years on Unsolved Mysteries. So that was.
Now tell me about that.
It was great. I was an investigative agent. I did what John Walsh does for America's Most Wanted for Unsolved Mysteries. And whenever it says update or you see the telephone center, that was when we were doing the hustle bustle of trying to get the criminal arrested. And oftentimes it happened before the show was over.
Tell me a little bit about this big signage we have over here.
Isn't it beautiful?
It really is.
That was the museum that I curate and that I work with and curate with is called the San Fernando Valley Relics Museum, and that is on loan here today from that museum. It's going to be going back in there. It is a museum that is a pop culture museum, and it collects things that you're not going to see that were in the valley and aren't in the valley any longer. So it's a fabulous piece of eclectic art. That piece is the Universal Monsters, and you can see there are six of them depicted on there. It's from the 60s. And it was on display in Universal City, and now it sits on display. After it leaves here, it goes to the Valley Relics Museum and sits on display there.
Amazing. And Universal Monster movies were the creators of the genre.
List to me of them all. They just really are. And two cute stories about Glenn being the Frankenstein monster. One is how he got the job being the Frankenstein monster. He was 6'6". His hands were huge, and you know him as Sam the bartender at Gunsmoke, so you know what his face looked like. And it was just ruddy, and he was so big that they were looking for someone new to play the monster. And Jack Pierce, the makeup man, said, if I had him, I'd be halfway through with my makeup before I got started. And 45 minutes later, $25 he paid him to do that, he had a new Frankenstein monster.
It's amazing. Yeah, Jack Pierce is just like the ultimate.
If I could go back and meet somebody, I would want to meet Jack Pierce. I just think that he just fascinates me. The other day, someone came into the museum and just blew me away. And it was, she was Florence Bush, the hair designer for everyone in the 60s, her daughter. And it just, I was so excited. I get excited about the odd things, you know, the credits. The people on the credits, to me, are every bit as fascinating, if not more, even than the actors.
You're from Hollywood royalty, so the things that stand out to you are more of the history.
Yeah, production value and everything. You know, you can feel what that movie is trying to do, from who's directing it. I can tell by watching it. I don't have to see the credits anymore. I guess that means I'm getting old.
It means that you are very knowledgeable. So where can we find you on social media? Can we find your website?
JulianneReed.com, JulianneReed on Facebook, and the Valley Relics Museum. And join the Valley Relics group on Facebook because that's what's going to show you what's happening fast. We do a lot of 60s meet and greets, and where we have Kathy Garber's coming in on May 30th for Family Affair. We do that a lot, so those things will be happening.
All right. Well, thank you so much for taking your time today, and it was a pleasure.